Hi, this is Abhyuday Singh Chauhan, Marketing Manager at Design & Buy. And today, we are going to talk about different ways through which you can not only make sure that your online printing business is visible to your audience, but you can also be among the first ones to be seen in your local area. Now, SEO is the most important thing when it comes to succeeding at online these days. And what matters the most is the digital word of mouth. So to make sure that your business is spreading the word digitally, you need to take care of a few things. So today, we are going to talk about the local SEO. So before we proceed, let us first see that why local SEO is that important and how can it help to increase your customers. Now the thing is that the customers are turning towards internet to find out the local businesses. And this is not only on the desktop, but on the mobile devices too. A survey report says that about 64% of the local customers use search engine and directories to find a local business, and about 89% of the people search local businesses through their smartphones, and that too at least once a week, and with 58% of these customers searching their businesses daily. So now that you know that why local SEO is that important, let us straight away move to the tactics that helps you increase your brand visibility in the local area. And the first comes the title and the meta description tags. Now, meta description is a piece of information that you see below your website's title on Google's search engine result page. So when someone looks for your business's website, the first thing they will see will be the name of your website and the title of your homepage. Now you can think this text as a mini ad that you need to carefully craft. Also, the title of your website's SERP result is equally important, as the user might get turned off by the title itself and never read the description below it. It is the first impression. And you know what they say about those. So, being to the point and honest about the services you provide is the simplest and the most trusted way to create a powerful title. Also note that according to the latest Google updates, the description is supposed to be from 150 to 300 characters. Any more than that, and you can run the risk of having an incomplete description. So, the takeaway here is that the space is precious and every word counts. So let me give you some tips for today. Never waste space on page names that don't provide helpful information. Also, if you want to reach local customers, you can include the name of your city, your businesses, and even the area your business serves. You need to focus on using one targeted keyword and carefully place that keyword as close to the beginning of the tag as you can. Now remember one thing, that if your business shows up in the search engine results, you have got only one shot at your customer to make him click your link. So, do not waste it by probably using characters or words that won't convince him. Alright? So let us straight away move to the second topic, that is gathering as many citations as possible for your local area. Now according to Google, every 4 out of 5 customers use search engines to conduct local searches. But most of their business have not even claimed a single local listing in your area. And that's a huge opportunity that is being missed. A digital citation is basically a mention of your business's name, address, and phone number. Now, citations are usually found on third-party websites that gather information on local businesses such as Yelp, Yellow Pages, Merchant Circle, City Search, and others. These websites will list your business as a printing business and it will be indexed along all the other printing businesses in your area. Now this is very important if you want to be found by the potential clients among all the other competitors. The more local citations you have, the more authoritative Google thinks your business is. You also need to be sure about your company's NAP, that it should be consistent across all the citations and directories. Because if Google is not sure, it might end up showcasing wrong information or might not show your brand at all. And now comes the Google My Business page. Now this is another sort of a directory, but this is a big one and hence it needs a special mention. Creating a Google My Business page is easy and gets done quickly. You just need to add your updated address, time of operation, phone number and other information as asked by the Google, and it will then use this information to guide people directly to your business when they look for similar services. Also note that according to Google's term of service, only a business owner can claim a GMB page. And once the listing is done, the next step is to optimize your Google My Business listing with a solid description, categories, business hours, type of payments accepted, and so on. Also make sure to upload logo, photos of your business, products and services. Try and fully populate each and every section of your listing and make it complete. And now comes the third tactic, that is the online reviews. Now, according to a survey, about 84% of the people trust online reviews as much as the personal recommendations. And 7 out of 10 are even ready to give a review if the business asks them to do so. Similarly, any website that has more reviews and within that a diversity of reviews will be considered genuine by Google. Now, people try to fool Google by adding review themselves, but Google realizes it. It considers several factors such as review velocity, review quantity, and review diversity, which means how many reviews have you acquired, how qualitative they are, and whether they are fake or real. An easy way to do this is to ask your customers to review on as much sites as possible, say Facebook, Just Dial, Yelp, etc. And to make sure that they do give their best and honest reviews, you can probably incentivize them or 10% on the next printing purchase. That would be a little boost to them. And now one thing for you to do is that whenever a review comes, say positive or negative, do reply to them, because that is how you show your viewers that how much you care about what customers think about you. And now, last but not the least, comes the final tactic, that is the structured data markup. A structured data markup is a piece of code that is a part of your website's backend design. Now this gives all the information about your business to Google's web crawlers, and hence it should be present on every page just to reinforce the credibility of your printing business. Now the thing is that only 31.3% of the websites use this markup, and out of those, most of the websites use only the basic ones. So there's an opportunity for you to stand out of the crowd and probably rank higher among your competitors. Structured data markup, which is often referred to as schema markup or schema.org markup, can be added to your website's code to provide search engines with the more information about your business. The image here shows that how a local business has placed their NAP in the footer of their website, marking it up with the schema.org. Well, all you just need to do is replace the text shown in black with your own details, and that's it. Also, there are many online tools for you to use in order to input the information needed by the web crawlers. One of them being the Google's own data highlighter. But do make sure that your website is linked up with the Google Search Console for this to work. Now, when it comes to local SEO, this is just the tip of the iceberg. And implementing these 5 tactics shall give you a head start among all your competitors. So get started today. Now, thanks for watching this video, and to stay updated about more such videos and ideas, you can subscribe to our YouTube channel or straight away connect to our website, that is www.designandby.com. Thanks for watching.